Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about the quality factor for parallel RLC circuit, as well as the bandwidth of parallel RLC circuit we are going to derive. In the previous video, we discussed the three different parallel RLC circuit and their resonant frequency, impedance, admittance, and the current value we derived at resonance. Okay, so if you want to watch that previous parallel RLC video as well as the series RLC video, I will give link in the description box. You can refer it. Okay, so already we derived the quality factor for series RLC circuit. Similarly, now we are going to derive the quality factor for parallel RLC circuit. Okay, so already you know the about quality factor. What is mean by quality factor? So quality factor is used to measure how in order to measure the quality of the given circuit, we are using the term, it is called as a quality factor. Okay, so how pure the circuit is, okay, that is the meaning. And the quality factor, it is defined as, it's a ratio of maximum energy stored to the maximum energy dissipated in one period. It is nothing but quality factor. Okay, so in parallel RLC, we are using the two energy element, energy storage element, you know, one is inductor, another one is capacitor. So this two thing, inductor and capacitor, is a energy storage element. So the quality factor is defined as, it's a ratio of how much energy stored divided by how much energy dissipated. That ratio we are calling it as a quality factor. If it is a good circuit, the quality factor value should be high. Okay, so you see the quality factor Q equal to 2 pi. Okay, why 2 pi? Means in one period. Okay, we are making calculation for one period. So 2 pi into maximum energy stored per cycle divided by energy dissipated per cycle. This is called as a quality factor. Okay. And the quality factor at resonance for the parallel RLC circuit is omega naught CR. So we derived the quality factor for series resonant circuit. It is 1 by omega naught CR. Okay. But for parallel RLC circuit, the quality factor is inverse of the series RLC circuit. Okay, so in series RLC, the quality factor is 1 by omega naught CR. For parallel RLC circuit, the quality factor is reciprocal of this. So omega naught CR. Okay, so this quality factor in terms of resonant frequency and capacitor value. Okay, if we want to derive it in terms of inductor, resistor and capacitor, means, so we have to substitute the omega naught value in the above equation. Okay, so you know, what is the resonant frequency of parallel RLC circuit? 1 by root LC. So you substitute this omega naught value in equation number 1. This equation, so the quality factor QR equal to omega naught RC. So instead of omega naught, you substitute 1 by root LC RC. Okay, so here, this C, it can be written as square root of C squared. So 1C cancel. So we can get R into square root of C by L. Okay, so this is a second formula, quality factor formula in terms of resistor, inductor and capacitor. But in series RLC circuit, the formula is that the reciprocal of this. Okay, so the reciprocal of this means 1 by R square root of L by C. This is the quality factor for series in terms of RLC. But for parallel circuit, R into square root of C by L. Okay, this is the second formula. Then if we want to derive in terms of inductor and resonant frequency, means, so you know, omega naught is 1 by root LC. So from that, omega naught squared is equal to 1 by LC. Okay, so from that, we just calculate C. So C equal to 1 by L into omega naught squared. So you substitute this C value in above equation. Okay, so in this equation number 1. In equation number 1, so we may get the quality factor is equal to omega naught CR. So instead of this C, okay, so instead of C, you substitute 1 by L into omega naught squared. So here, 1 omega naught cancel. So what is the answer? R by omega naught L. Okay, but for series RLC circuit, the quality factor formula is omega naught L by R. Okay, so here for parallel RLC circuit, you see, it's a reverse, it's the inverse of this. Okay, so finally, So what are the three different formula for the quality factor of parallel RLC circuit or anti-resonant circuit? So you see R by omega naught L, or otherwise omega naught RC, or R into square root of C by L. So these are all the three quality factor for parallel RLC circuit. But it is for series RLC circuit, the inverse of each thing. Okay, one is omega naught L by R. Another one is 1 by omega naught RC. Another one is 1 by R square root of L by C. That is a resonant frequency formula for the series RLC circuit. Okay, so already we discussed in the previous video. If you want to watch that quality factor of series RLC circuit, I will give link in the description box. You can refer it. Okay, and the next one, we are going to derive the bandwidth of parallel RLC circuit. Okay. And already we derived the bandwidth for series RLC circuit. So it is also a very important big question. So similarly, we are going to derive the bandwidth for parallel RLC circuit. Okay. So already you know the definition for bandwidth. What is bandwidth? The bandwidth means the range of frequency. Okay. In series RLC circuit, the definition is the range of frequency over which the current flowing is appreciably maximum. Okay. Maximum. But here, the bandwidth is nothing but the bandwidth of parallel RLC circuit is the range of frequency over which the power reaches 2 times the resonant power. Okay, so 2 times the resonant power. In which range of frequency the power is maximum. Okay, 2 times the resonant power. At that range of frequency, we are calling it as a bandwidth. Or otherwise, the bandwidth is defined as the difference between the two cutoff frequency, upper cutoff and lower cutoff. Okay, so you see the bandwidth is given by FH minus FL. This is the bandwidth in hertz. If we want to find the bandwidth in radian, means omega H minus omega L. Okay, what is omega H? Higher cutoff frequency, or omega U, upper or higher, you may refer. Omega L is the lower cutoff frequency. So the difference between the two cutoff frequency, we are calling it as a bandwidth. Okay, so and now we are going to derive the formula for this bandwidth. So in order to derive the bandwidth formula, so first we have to write the power in this parallel RLC circuit. So what is the power formula? The power is nothing but the general formula is I squared R. Okay. And what is I? I is a current flowing through that parallel RLC circuit. So that the total current I is nothing but the total voltage divided by the total impedance to the whole squared into R. Okay. Or otherwise, 1 by Z, you can return as Y. So V into Y the whole squared into R. Okay. And you know the value of Y. Okay. The admittance value already we derived in the previous, that is for ideal RLC circuit, you know. So you see, in previous video, we derived the admittance of each parallel RLC circuit and resonant frequency we derived. So in that you see, what is the admittance? The admittance Y is nothing but 1 by R plus J omega C minus 1 by omega L. Okay, this is the admittance of our parallel RLC circuit. Okay, so here you substitute that Y value. So you see, so here, so the Y value, this Y is 1 by, so the magnitude of Y is 1 by R squared plus omega C minus 1 by omega L the whole squared. Okay. Here we are substituting only the magnitude. Okay, square root of this. So square root square cancelled. So V squared into this into R. Okay, so this is the power in RLC circuit. So you just consider this is the equation number one. Next one, we have to derive the power at resonance. Okay, so you know in parallel RLC circuit, the power, okay, the current value is minimum in resonant. Similarly, the power is also minimum in resonance. Okay, in resonance frequency, the power reaches minimum as well as the current is also reaches minimum. So the power at resonance is equal to current at resonance squared into R. So what is the current at resonance? V divided by ZR. What is the ZR? What is the impedance at the resonance condition? You know, it is a simply R. So V squared by R squared into R, 1 R cancel. So we may get V squared divided by R. So this is the power at resonance. Okay, this value. This is the power at resonance. Okay, in resonance, the power reaches minimum value. Okay, so here the bandwidth is nothing but the range of frequency. Okay, the range of frequency over which the power reaches 2 times the resonant power. Okay, so this is the higher cutoff frequency and this one is the lower cutoff frequency. So difference between the two thing is called as the bandwidth. Okay, so you see, so in order to derive this bandwidth, so first you should know the definition. So you see, this is the power graph. So the power reaches minimum value at a resonance condition. So this is omega r. So the at omega r, what is the power? That power is PR. So the bandwidth is nothing but the range of frequency. This is omega h. This is omega l. This is omega h. The range of frequency over which the power is 2 times the resonant power. Okay, so where 2 times the resonant power, you know, you draw one line, that range of frequency, it is called as a bandwidth. Okay, so we derived the power formula separately, power at resonance separately. So according to the definition, at cutoff frequency omega h and omega l, the power will be equal to twice the power at resonance. So we may write P equal to 2 into PR. Okay, the power will be equal to twice the resonance power. So the what is the PR value? V squared by R. What is the P value? You see, this is the equation number 1. Okay, so you just substitute. So 2 into PR. This side, this is P. So P is V squared into this one into R equal to 2 into V squared by R. Okay, so here V squared cancel. Okay, then this R, you give it to this side. So 1 by R the whole square plus omega C minus 1 by omega L the whole square is equal to 2 by R square. Okay, then this 1 by R square or this 2 by R square, you give it to left side. Okay, so you now you subtract these two terms, minus 2 by R square, 1 by R square. If you are subtracting, we can get minus 1 by R square. And this term as it is, you write. Okay, then omega c minus 1 by omega l the whole squared is equal to 1 by r squared. Okay, so a squared is equal to this. So a equal to plus r minus that particular root. So omega c minus 1 by omega l, you can write it as plus r minus 1 by r. Okay, then from that you cross multiply. Okay, so if I cross multiplying, omega squared lc minus 1 divided by omega l is equal to plus r minus 1 by r. Okay, then you give this omega l to that side. So omega squared lc minus 1 is equal to plus r minus omega l by r. Then this part you give it to left side totally. So omega squared lc minus 1, this plus r minus, if you are coming to this side, means minus r plus omega l by r equal to 0. So this is the one quadratic equation. You just divide this entire equation by the constant LC. So we can get, if you are dividing the first term by LC, omega squared. If you are dividing minus 1 by LC, mean minus 1 by LC. If you are dividing this by LC, means we can get omega by RC equal to 0. Okay, so you see this equation. So in this equation, there are two quadratic equations are there. In second, if you are substituting minus, means we can get this equation. If here plus means, we can get this equation. Okay, so this equation you split into equation number 3 and equation number 4. So if you are solving this third equation, we can get the two roots. Okay, if you are solving this equation, we can get the two roots. So already you know the method in order to find the roots of this quadratic equation. This quadratic equation is in the structure ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. Okay, so if the equation is like this, means the root of this equation is calculated by minus b plus r minus square root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. Okay, this is the roots of this above equation. So you see this equation number 3. So what is the coefficient for omega squared? 1. So a is 1. B is 1 by RC. C is minus 1 by LC. So if you are substituting, so the root of the third equation is omega 1 comma 2 is minus B plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4as1c divided by 2a. Okay, so this 1 by 2 you give it to each term, so minus 1 by 2rc plus or minus 1 by 2 this. Okay, so from that the first root is minus 1 by 2rc plus 1 by 2, this term is a first root. Second root is minus 1 by 2rc minus 1 by 2 into this is a second root. Okay, in this two root the omega 2 you see minus minus, so the answer for this root is entirely negative. Okay, but the frequency is not a negative. Okay, the frequency is always positive, so that's why you neglect this root, you keep this root omega 1 as it is. Okay, then similarly you have to find the root for the fourth equation. Okay, so using the same method you may find the roots of that equation. So omega 3 comma 4, third root and fourth root is calculated by the same method you follow. So we can get the two root omega 3 omega 4. So you see omega 3 is this, omega 4 is this. Okay, so out of this this root is negative. Okay, so if you are calculating the answer for this we may get negative root, so neglect the two negative root, you take two positive root. Okay, so here that omega 1 is a lower cutoff frequency, this omega 3, you see this omega 3, it is a higher cutoff frequency. So you see the formula for upper cutoff frequency, 1 by 2 rc plus 1 by 2 square root of 1 by rc the whole square plus 4 by lc. Lower cutoff frequency is minus 1 by 2 rc, only the difference is here plus 1 by 2 rc, here minus 1 by 2 rc, remaining term as it is same. Okay, this is the lower cutoff frequency. Okay, so we derived the two half power frequencies, and from that if you are taking the difference between these two cutoff frequency we can get the bandwidth. So the bandwidth is equal to difference between the higher cutoff frequency and lower cutoff frequency. So if you are subtracting this upper cutoff frequency minus this lower cutoff frequency, this second term entirely gets cancelled. So 1 by 2 rc minus of minus 1 by 2 rc, so 2 times 1 by 2 rc, so we can get 1 by rc. So this is the bandwidth of parallel rlc circuit in radians. Okay, similarly if you want to find the bandwidth in hertz means, okay, fh minus fl, if you want to derive the bandwidth in hertz means you just divide by 2 pi. So the bandwidth of parallel rlc circuit in hertz means, so 1 by 2 pi rc hertz. Okay, this is the bandwidth. So this procedure is same as that of the series rlc circuit. Okay, so in series rlc circuit also, but in series rlc circuit that is the frequency is called as a half power frequency. Okay, that is in that case the power at resonance is maximum. Okay, so in that series rlc circuit we are defining the cutoff frequency as whenever the power reaches half of the maximum power, but in parallel RLC circuit, the range of frequency over which the power reaches 2 times the resonant frequency. That is the difference between the two things. Okay, so remaining as usual, we have to derive the two quadratic equation. By solving the two quadratic equation, we can get the four roots. Out of that four root, two roots are negative. Always the frequency is positive. So you neglect the two negative root, you take two positive root. The higher value is called as a upper cutoff frequency. The lower value is called as a lower cutoff frequency. If you are subtracting the two cutoff frequency, we can get the bandwidth. So the bandwidth for the parallel RLC circuit, finally we derived 1 by RC. This is the bandwidth in radians. If you want to find the bandwidth in hertz mean, you just divide by 2 pi. So 1 by 2 pi RC is a bandwidth in hertz. Okay. Then the next one, selectivity. So already you know the definition for selectivity. Okay, the selectivity, it is defined as it's a ratio of resonant frequency to the bandwidth. Okay, so the selectivity is nothing but resonant frequency omega naught by bandwidth. So here what is the bandwidth for a parallel RLC circuit? 1 by LC. So omega naught RC. What is omega naught RC? It is nothing but the quality factor of our parallel RLC circuit. So here the selectivity is nothing but the quality factor of the parallel RLC circuit. Okay, So the selectivity definition, it is same as that of the series RLC as well as the parallel RLC circuit. Okay, so this is about the parallel RLC circuit. Okay, so in the next video we are going to derive what is the current flowing through resistor, inductor and capacitor in a parallel RLC circuit at a resonance condition. Okay, so we will derive it in next video. So thanks for watching my channel, and please subscribe my channel for more videos. If you want to learn all lecture videos about the subject circuit analysis in my channel, in the name of circuit analysis, one playlist is there. As well as in the name of circuit analysis MCQ, another one playlist is there. In that playlist, all 2 more problems are solved in order. Okay, so I will give link in for that playlist in the description box. As well as for series RLC circuit and for the remaining video for the parallel RLC circuit, I will give link for that videos in the description box. You can refer it. Okay, so thank you. We will meet in the next video.